Italian truck. It's just pulling up, someone hopped out. A big goofy nigga, he tryna look tough. I'm like, what he tryna do? So I clutch my move, but he kept walking. He don't want no smoke, boy, he not bulletproof. Just got some clout from this stripper bitch. She from Kentucky, she just tell the clock with a bullet clip. Boy, don't play me, boy, don't play me. Met her at the spot, you know how it goes. You know how it goes. So I bought some dope and took her to the O. Just got her out from this stripper.
Hashtag Doc Spills Live. Come on. Hashtag right now, Doc Spills Live. Let's get it, baby. Hashtag Doc Spills Live. Hashtag Morning Blow, baby. Hashtag Doc Spills Live. Hashtag Doc Spills Live. Hashtag Morning Blow. Come on. Doc Spills Live. And then come back and hashtag that Morning Blow. That way people can follow this motherfucker. Let's go. To the O. Hashtag Doc Spills Live. Hashtag Morning Blow. Let's go. I'm jamming some King Von this morning. Jamming some King Von this morning. Jamming some King Von.
Now, this morning, to all that, you just have to really understand.
Jamming some King Von this morning. Come on, let's get on this live. I got something to share with you this morning. You're gonna love this. Hashtag Morning Blow.
Von.
Come on.
Let me tell you what it's like. 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 Yeah. Let me tell you what it's like.
Let me tell you what it's like. Let me tell you what it's like.
When you fight for your life.
When you're fighting for your life, let me tell you what it's like. Let me tell you what it's like. When you're fighting for your life, let's go, let's go.
Fighting 40 by the life. In a room with a hype or a nigga you don't like. When you seen your homie first thing that he gave you was a knife.
Today,
you don't know how I feel.
We're gonna talk about desire. Today's Morning Blow, we're gonna talk about desire. Make sure you hear me. Today's Morning Blow, we're gonna talk about desire. I want y'all to hear me. Today's Morning Blow, fighting for your life. We're talking about desire. Now, I'm going to be talking to you guys, and I want you to do me a favor. When you're on my Morning Blow, the reason why I set this up is because I have a lot of you who ask for mentorship, who want mentorship. Share this right now. Come on, tag some people in this bitch. Share them. Come on, get people on Morning Blow. I go through mine. I hit the little arrow, and I tag people on it, and I say, hey, man, get on this Morning Blow with me. Get on this Morning Blow. I just invite everybody. Look, if you in my friends, I'm sorry, you're getting that invite. And I send it out to all the people there. So you go and do the same thing, and you can help me reach more people who want someone speaking the truth. I had a little incident happen yesterday. And it's only for a few minutes, but I had a little incident yesterday. Well, I watched this guy talk about people in our profession of network marketing. You know, and he's just really come against people in network marketing. But I think he misses the real psychological premise of network marketing. And that psychological premise is that what makes network marketing different is the personal development that is connected to network marketing. That personal development is really what is taking my life to the next level. Personal development is not mumbo jumbo. Personal development, guys, is what takes your level from one level to the next. And so if you commit to some personal development, I promise you, that's what this Morning Blow is about. When you commit to some personal development, I promise you, you'll start seeing your life go to next levels. And that's why I did this, because I want to be able to come back, smoke my weed, and then give you some shit, some truths from my life, proverbs from my life, on what changed my life. So this morning, we only do it for a few minutes. And then I share. So let's run it up. We're going to talk about desire. And I want you to write this down. There's not enough teaching on the word desire. Good morning, good morning, good morning. There's not enough teaching on the word desire. And I think desire gets a bad rap.
So
I think desire gets a bad rap, right? I think desire gets a bad rap. Now, why do I think desire gets a bad rap? Because most of you who have some type of morality background or some type of faith-based background has connected desire to sin. Seriously, most people connect desire to sin. In other words, that's why there's not a lot of teaching on it. People don't know how to go after their desires because we've been taught that our desires should be suppressed. We should not go after our desires because our desires should be suppressed. Are you hearing me? We should not go after our desires. Why? Because our desires, we suppress them, right? We don't go after that because desires are usually out of a place called ego, right? And when something comes out of ego, we usually push back from it. Oh no, that's ego. Don't do this. Don't do that. No. You've been told to sacrifice your desires even for responsibilities. Many of you right now don't even pursue your desires right now because you have something called responsibilities. I want you to write this down. Responsibilities, come on guys, are dream killers. If you ever want to know a dream killer, just look at responsibility. Responsibility is the biggest dream killer there is. Modo fuego. Modo fuego. Responsibility. I'm serious. Do you know how many people don't do what they love because of responsibility? Do you know how many people don't do what they love? What's up, Nazir? Come on. How many of you don't do what you do, do what you want to do right now because you have responsibilities? You got children. You got husband, wife. You got bills. And those bills make you take a job you don't love. Those bills make you take a job you don't want. Those bills make you be employed in a place you don't want. Responsibilities, come on, catch it, are dream killers. How many of y'all would agree with me? If you agree with Spills right now, go ahead and type in responsibilities of dream killers. You can't write the book because you're too busy. Right? You can't start the business because you're too busy. You can't do what you need to do because you're too busy. Busy, watch this now, is really not busy. Write down the word busy. B-U-S-Y. Busy. Now, write down the word business. B-U-S-I-N-E-S-S. Now, you can't be busy if you don't have a business. See how those two words are connected? So if you don't have a business, you're not busy. If you don't have a business, you're just preoccupied. Responsibilities are dream killers. If you're busy, no. Busy means you have a business. That's where those two words are connected. Busy, business. Busy, business. Busy, business. But you're busy building someone else's business. So then what you really are is preoccupied. Anytime someone comes and tell you, oh, babe, I'm busy, then that says, oh, you're building your business. Oh, no, I'm busy doing this. No, you're not busy. You're just preoccupied. How many of you would agree with me that responsibilities are dream killers? And not only is responsibilities dream killers, watch this. Busy people are really not busy because busy people usually don't have a business. And if you have a business, sweetheart, in this morning blow, you're not busy. You're just preoccupied. Now, what are you preoccupied doing? You're preoccupied building someone else's busy. Come on, teach this morning. This is morning blow. You're busy building someone else's busy. You're busy building someone else's busy. You're not busy building your business. You're busy building someone else's busy. So the first thing we got to do is get you to understand you're really not busy. What you are is preoccupied with someone else's busy. Babe, you preoccupied. Come on. Hashtag RNS. Hashtag RNS. Hashtag RNS. Real nigga shit. I just dropped some right there. Hashtag RNS. Real nigga shit right there. Now, I want you to get this because this is a grown-up morning blow. All my morning blows are grown-up. If you have a sensitive ear, you're not going to stay on this live. But I got to teach you the truth. I got to tell you. Hashtag real nigga shit. Now, What is desire? What is desire? Because if you're going to go after your desires, you first got to know what a desire is. Now, if you know I'm kicking some real live stuff, I want you to go hit that triangle on your screen and invite some people onto this live saying, this bro, y'all need to hear what he's saying. This morning blow is off the chains. Go ahead and mention it in your mentions. If you busy and you don't have a business, you just preoccupied. Come on. You ought to put that in your mentions. If you busy, if you say you busy and you don't have a business, you just preoccupied. Hashtag real nigga shit. Now watch this. So what we got to do is get busy people to get busy. Listen, we got to get busy people. Listen, we got to get busy people busy about their desires. Because if I get you busy about their desires, you know I'm going to save this live for you and this morning blow, you'll be able to go back and watch it. But if I get you busy about your desires, I can finally get you to get something off the ground. I need you to say this. If I get busy about my desires, I can finally get something off the ground. For me, for my name, for my legacy. I need you to hear me. If I was you, I'd be typing at and putting people on this live right now, because there's some people you know right now. If you at them right now, they'll get on this live and say, what is he talking about? Why? Because you need them to know, listen, bro, you're really not busy like you told me. This bro just said you just preoccupied. And what I want to get you to do is to be busy about your desire. Now, what I'm going to do after you start hitting at and connecting people to this live, watch this. I'm going to define desire for you. A strong feeling, huh? A strong feeling.
I'm looking at GJ right now.
A strong feeling of wanting something. That's the basic principle of desire. A strong feeling of wanting something. Now, this is what you have to understand. It is God who puts desires in your heart. So every desire you have comes from God. I need you to understand, it is God that puts desires in your heart. I didn't say that. He said that. It is God who puts desires in your heart. What does it say to that? What does it say God puts desires in my heart? I ain't never heard that. Yeah. Philippians 2:13 says, God puts those desires in our heart. So then every desire you have, it was placed there by God. So then desires come from creation. So from creation, you were created to do something, and that desire pulls on you. 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 So he puts it there. You got it there because God put it there. I ain't put it there. You ain't put it there. The Creator put it there. There is something inside of you that the Creator wants to come out of you. There is something inside of you that the Creator wants to come out of you. Now, how the Creator gonna get it? He's not gonna get it out of you until there's a yearning in you. He puts a yearning in you. Now, I need you to hear me. He puts a yearning in you. He puts a yearning in you. A yearning, a hunger. You're not satisfied till you're doing it. How many of you understand that? You're in a place right now, and you're saying, I just don't feel satisfied if I'm not doing this. I don't feel complete if I'm not doing this. I don't feel whole if I'm not doing this. What is the thing that you do that you feel whole about? Catch that. Catch it in this morning blow. What is the thing, come on, in this morning blow, what is the thing, listen to me, what is the thing that you need that makes you whole? I feel incomplete if I'm not doing it. That's your desire. That's it. Fire up on that chip. What is it that you just long to do, have to do? You get lost in it. You have to do it. You get lost in it. What you obsess over? Catch that. Now watch this. There are five desires we all have. I'll give them to you. There are five desires we typically have. The first desire is the desire for wealth. The second desire is for sex. The third desire is for fame. The fourth desire is for food. The fifth desire is for sleep. There are five desires we all have. Psychologists have said this. There are five desires men have. The desire for wealth, write this down. There's desire, the first desire. Second desire is sex. Third desire, fame. Fourth desire, food. Fifth desire, sleep. All your desires fall into that category. There is not one category that you can name that doesn't fall into. Wealth, sex, fame, food, sleep. There's only five desires that we have. Now, I need you to understand that it was, when you understand those five desires, the five desires that we have, you then understand that you're in those categories. Y'all may hear me. Y'all hear me. You understand you're in those categories. Let me go deeper. Let me go deeper. I got a few more minutes left. Let me go deeper. And he's saying, I don't care for fame. I'm sorry. I disagree. I'm sorry. I do not believe that you don't fall in those five. Now, you say you don't claim for fame, but just let me finish. Fame ain't the stage, bro. How about fame is just a good reputation? It ain't. No. How about fame is just a good reputation? Everybody want fame. You just want a good reputation. And it falls into those five. And each one of those five, if you understand it, you'll understand, watch this now, where we are throughout the day. Throughout the day, five things pull on us. Throughout the day, five things pull on us. Throughout the day, five things pull on us. We're talking about desires. Throughout the day, five things pull on us. Throughout the day, five things pull on us. Those five things, wealth pulls on us. Fame pulls on us. Right? All of them pulls on us. All of them pulls on us. Y'all think fame is just getting on TV. No. Fame is a good reputation, bro. You want a good reputation, you're going to build your fame. Good reputation, fame, good credit. A good credit is fame. 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 Almost 2 years ago. A good reputation. Why is God? Because God is in all of them.
By the way, that was
before God. Each five, God is in all five. So then there is nothing in him. In him we live, in him we move, in him we have our being. So God is in all five. God is not in none of, God is in all of that. There is not none of that that God is not in. You can't see none of that. God is in all of it. He encompasses all of that. Wealth, sleep, rest, because you need the rest. He's in all of it. I want you to transcend in your thinking. I'm neurocasting to you today. And in this neurocasting broadcast, I want you to go after your desire today. What is the thing that you hunger for? What is the thing that you want to do? I need you to stop denying yourself of life's good today. Today, I want you to stop denying yourself of life's good, and I want you to go after desires in your heart. There's some things inside of you that you need to go after. There's some things that you want you need to go after. You've sacrificed enough for others. It's now time to do it for you. Now, listen, I know what people are going to say. We don't teach selfishness, but I'm trying to tell you it's okay to be selfish, because selfish is self-preservation. And if you don't preserve yourself, you won't be here for yourself. If you don't preserve yourself, hashtag, if you don't preserve yourself, you won't be here for yourself. And many of you are so busy going after other people and helping other people that you're neglecting yourself. And self is the first right of preservation. And until you take care of you, boo, until you take care of you, bro, ain't nobody gonna take care of you. Your desires is how you take care of you. And when you sacrifice your desires, you sacrifice your welfare. When you sacrifice your desires, you sacrifice who you are. You should never sacrifice your desires, not for a relationship, not for people, not for nobody. Your desires are what keep you in line, because desires are goals. I need you to understand. Your desires are goals. Finish it. I got a few seconds left. Your desires are goals.
We're good.
Your desires are goals. And if you're going to go, you should go home. Today, Morning Blow, put your desires first. Your desires take care of you, not your man. Your man don't take care of you. Your desires did. That's how you got the man. Your woman don't take care of you. Your desires did. That's how you got the woman. Your desires take care of you, not the people you with. Your desires take care of you, not the company. Your company don't take care of you. Your desires did. Your desires led you to the company. It's always been your desires that have taken care of you. Your desires, what you want. What you want is taking care of you. When do you start doing what you want? How many of you are going to keep sacrificing for others that wouldn't sacrifice for you? Come on, this is a real Morning Blow. I got a few seconds. I got a few seconds. How many of you are tired of sacrificing for others that ain't gonna sacrifice for you.
And I'm gonna say this move.
Your desires are what's meant to take care of you.
There.
And God put those desires there. You don't sacrifice those desires. Because to sacrifice desire is to sacrifice God. That's where I close.
But I'm gonna give you
that's my last point.
That
to sacrifice your desire is to sacrifice God.
Oh, that's only really
important. When you sacrifice your desire, you kill the God in you. Because it was God who put the desire there in the first place. If you ever want to kill God in you, kill the desire in you. If you ever want to kill the God in you, kill the desire in you. It was God who put that there. God said, I gave you the desire. Now, when you kill that desire, you kill the part of me. Once you kill that desire, you've killed me. You're going to die just like everybody else. You're going to live just like everybody else. When Robert kills the desire, you're going to live just like everybody else, Robert. Come on, come on, come on. Fonz, if you kill your desire, you're going to die just like everybody else. I need y'all to catch what I'm saying. Sylvia, if you kill your desire, you're going to die just like everybody else. When you kill your desire, you choose to die just like everybody else. You kill your divinity. You kill your promise. You kill your potential. You kill your name. You kill your power. You kill your prestige. You kill your wealth. You kill your drive. You kill your money. This is the truth. Anytime you sacrifice your desire, you kill, you destroy the God in you. Now, how many gods died? How many gods are in the cemetery and never became? How many gods are busy, but are really preoccupied, pretending to be busy, because they ain't doing nothing for their last name? My niggas, don't kill God. Let him live by going after your desire. That's my morning blow. I hope y'all heard that. Don't kill God.
I know we don't go back and look at the past and talk about the past.
Don't kill God.
You don't hear that.
Don't kill God, man.
The only reason that I
don't kill him.
I bring it up.
Let him live.
If you can understand.
Let him live in you through your desires.
You
sacrificed enough.